Another step back into the archives of model kits, the vintage police car from AMT through round two models. This was sent to me by Model Roundup. This is in stock and ready to ship, so let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the 1/25th scale model when you get yours. We got some loose parts we can go over. First up is this beautiful little steering wheel. What I've noticed is that the details on this kit when I pulled them out of the box are really fine. Speaking of fine details, just to show you an example, look at the wire wheels on this car. Beautifully done. They're two-part wheels will glue together. Look at that little windshield wiper on there. And it's not completely flashed over. We got our spare tire, more of our wheels, our suspension. What flash is on the mold will be pretty darn easy to clean up. We got our steering link here, cylinder head. We can build it as a stock four-cylinder or a modified four-cylinder if you wish. The parts are in the box, two-in-one with the engine. Nice spoke wheels on there with the two-part, our pedals, fans, drive line in the back there. Cool, I love these tees. I'm always going to build them when they come out. We've got our four-banger right there, the sides and the bottom of the engine. Nice tuck-and-roll seat. We've got where we can put the top on or leave it open. We've got our two-part top there. It also comes with sides. We'll see that in a little bit. We've got the other half to our spare tire with those excellent spokes. I'm really impressed by being an older mold but yet having the spokes that nice. We've got police accessory parts here. We got a sawed-off shotgun. We have nightsticks. We have what I think is one of those crank sirens where they spin it up. We've got a megaphone in two halves. And we got the copper hats. Yeah, see? Copper. We got the hats right there. So that's pretty cool, little police accessory parts. I know that law enforcement vehicles are really popular with the model community. We've got a nice, large one-piece fender and floor assembly on this car, which will make things a lot nicer. We got a little bit of crispy flash, I like to call it. And with a swipe of a knife, that is gone. Same as the fenders there, no issues at all. Beautiful, strong detail on the running boards. Underneath looks nice and tight. That'll make things easier. Speaking of making things easier, a one-piece frame on something this small. I really do appreciate that one-piece frame. We got our suspension front and rear molded in that will key into mounting locations underneath for us to line it up. And our exhaust is mounted in place, and we can easily hand paint that. We will see me do that and show you how quick and easy it is. We got the nice hood here, all one piece, which makes displaying a lot easier. You could always cut that if you so desire. AMT, the round two plastic that they use, cuts super easy when you want a detail. We've got our interior tub here with the back seat. This is a four-door T. We'll be able to put our front seat in. We've got nice molding in that industrial floor down there. We've got nice molding inside the door panels. We can accentuate that with some shadowing. We've got our main body here. You can see the door panels are prominent and look great with the hinges. The molds are straight. We've even got our vent on the back of the hood. All nice looking, and this is its own piece, so we'll be able to paint that separately from those fenders if you want to do a two-tone paint job. Let's go to the other side of the table where I keep the chrome tree. We can see that the parts that should be chrome are pretty much chrome. We'll be able to paint over everything, but like here's your optional valve covers for the modified police engine with molding in them. We've got our cover for the engine in chrome. We've got all kinds of chrome police accessories. Check out that star. We've got our lights. We've got our emblems. We've got our nice bumpers with our license plates molded together. We've got our exhaust manifold for the modified police engine in chrome. We've got our bumperettes for the back. Nice grill surround, beautiful grill surround with the Ford emblem there. Headlight buckets, optional engine parts extended. Got the giant shifter there. Look at the size of that thing. It's enormous. Also in the box will be our glass options. We've got our stock glass, side lights, we've got our headlight glass, we've got the optional side curtains which are molded in clear, and then you would just run tape where the glass is and spray that your chosen color, mostly black, for around there. And then this little acetate part here is also in the, I don't know what it is, we'll find out when I get to it in the instructions and we'll talk about that and I'll let you know at that time. You've got two metal axles, I just have one in my hand, but we have two metal axles which on builds like this help a lot because of the fact that it's a very thin suspension assembly, and these will keep things from drooping and sagging later. I wish I had that option on myself. We got some beautiful vinyl tires with excellent tread pattern and sidewall pattern. I don't see a brand name. If one pops out to me later, I'll let you know. But those are four of those. The spare tire is one wheel paint. And last up, the unique decals to this kit. It's half black, half white. The same ones that are on this side in white if you can't see them. We have our PD emblems surrounded by white. We have the vintage license plates, which are beautiful. And then we have all our police logos and scroll work for the precinct on there, matched in white on the exact other side. So that is everything that's in the box that I got from Model Roundup. I will see you as soon as I get things together. It took me a couple hours to get to this point, and not because of difficulty, but because we wanted to clean up a little bit of the flash, open up some holes where our headlights will mount, and because some of the parts are smaller, and I wanted the glue to set before I moved on to the next step, so it just takes a little bit longer. We've got parts separated so I can get things painted. On this tree alone will be the fan, so I can get that painted. On this one, I assembled the steering wheel, glued it together with model glue. We've got our radiator tank, our radiator grill, our brake there, our windshield frame with windshield wiper, and our supports for the soft top. Those are all going to be the same color, so we're just going to paint those all on one tree. The spare tire mount will be the same color as the fenders, so that is on one tree all by itself, so I can get that painted. We've got our spare tire here. You can see that's a two-part. You glue the spokes together so you get that Y pattern in the spokes, and that looks really cool on there. That's the way they recommended doing it. They do the same with the main wheels when you glue them together to get that cool pattern in there, and they look lovely. You glue the two halves together with model glue, and now we can get over there and get those painted, and they're really nice and fine. On this part here, this is your headlights and your license plate mount that go across the front. Now it looks a little dirty because I used super glue to put those together. The manual gives you this nice template. They tell you to tape it right over there and then attach your headlights with the little mounts off to the sides. Just tape the chrome part with the license plate down and then glue your two lights on the side. Now you can remove the chrome and use model glue. I use super glue and activator because I have no issues with clamping this off, repainting it, priming it, and repainting it with chrome paint. But you can also remove the chrome. You can also use different types of cement or whatever glue. Model cement will not join chrome to chrome parts unless you remove the chrome and expose bare plastic. We've got the front seat together. It just gets its back pushed on and glued on. That looks fine. There really isn't much assembly with the accessories except for putting the megaphone together, the hats, the shotgun, the baton, the crank siren. Those all need to be painted and hand detailed, so those will be sitting over there. We've got our soft top glued together. Very easy to do. Just lay it in there and run your bead of glue in there and you are all set to go. That will weld itself together beautifully. The four-cylinder engine is a nice little work of art. These Model T engines are beautiful from AMT. I did the completely stock engine. Go ahead, do the souped up version if you wish. All the parts are in there. And if you ever build another one, you could build two versions of it. One souped up and one stock. I like stock on these. It's just a thing for me. I really like the stock Model Ts. We've got our interior and hood ready to go. The hood just needed some cleanup, some flash removal, and that is all set for paint. We've got our interior and our body that sit on the chassis. I left this little wing after I glued it on. What I did was I laid the interior in, put the dashboard across, used some Tamiya glue because it's got a real thin applicator, glued the dashboard on without gluing it to the body, and now I can remove it and get the interior and the dashboard painted as one and not have to worry about super glue on that small area later when I line things up, and then I can just snip, snip, and touch up the paint like I always do. The body goes together well, clean up a little bit of flash, attach your firewall, notches in from the back, and it will fit beautifully and you won't have to worry a thing about it. You've got your fender assembly, body assembly here. You'll need to clean up the flash that will be existent on the bumper mounts. That's about it. Clean out your wheel wells. I leave this attached so I can clamp it. I can just cut this off and touch up the color on the side easily, and attach your horn, which is what they recommend since it'll be painted the same color as the fenders. The chassis on this is beautiful, like the other Model T chassis. We are all set up with our suspension. The engine will mount in here, so what I did to line up these parts for the driveline and the front suspension is I just mounted the engine in place, lined everything up, glued it into place, and then we don't have to worry about lining it up later. You can see how that front suspension goes on. I cleaned up a little bit of flashing between the webbing there. I added the wheel backs, or the brake assemblies on the back of each one. I slide the metal axles into these because they are very much exposed on the front, not exposed at all on the rear, but it still helps hold everything tight and rigid. So then I will be able to spray those all as one and get those color coded right away and get the suspension in the front stiffened up with that wire, and the paint will hold it into place. It fits perfectly and doesn't need to go anywhere. So we will be all set with that. That is a nice assembly. I'm gonna hit paint and you're gonna see what colors I've picked out. All right, let me get you all caught up on the work that I've been doing. Also, question for the regular viewers. I usually use a brownish towel. I've got these old army surplus towels as well. Let me know which building towel you prefer. I always love building over a towel. Keeps everything clean. I can wash these when I get paint on them. Easier than I can wash the whole desk. It's hard to get the whole desk into the washing machine. And it helps with when you put stuff upside down that's painted. You're not going to ruin it when it's on that surface. So let's take a look. Let me know, you know, in the comments, did you like the brown towels when I film, or the green towels, or it doesn't matter. So I'm working on stuff. What I did was I took a silver pen and highlighted the attachment points of the side glass, the little cowling glass that'll go on either side of the windshield when we're done. You can see the mounts for it, the upper and lower mounts for each piece of that glass. So once that's attached to the car, I'll be adding the little side light glass down there. But we've got the windshield in. You saw me attach that with Mod Podge. We let that dry and it becomes virtually invisible. Blends right in with the glossy frame and it looks outstanding. And then I did a little bit of metallic on the windshield wiper just to draw it out and give it a little bit stronger look to it. Got the wheel and tire package all done with the little hubcaps. Those look awesome. I really like that dark red look on there. Got our spare tire done with the exact same look. That has to be mounted to the frame at the end. Got our mount there, just attach that with some super glue. That's what I use to attach all the little parts later, is just a little tiny bit of super glue or crazy glue. Got the headlights together. You saw that that used to be chrome. I sprayed it black, then I chromed it with Rust-Oleum Bright Coat Chrome, and then attached the trim rings and the headlights with, again, Mod Podge, and you can see how lovely that assembly comes out. Now we'll be able to line that up on the front fender so much easier. Glued the radiator together. I like the chrome on the radiator, the flat black on the radiator surround and everything, so we're all set on that. It just needs its little crank, and then we need the valve cap on the top, or the radiator cap on the top. Our helmets have dried. They're not the exact same blue. They're a nice little darker blue that I chose. Got our shotgun done, glossed up the nightsticks, glossed up the megaphone just a little bit. Got the back crank to the siren. We'll attach the chrome part on the front, and those will be all done. So those look pretty cool. Those will just be strewn around the interior for added effect. We've got our little extra spotlights that they would have had. So I've got those glued together with Mod Podge. Remember, I didn't know what that clear piece of Lexan was in the glass. That's for the back glass on the cabin here, on the convertible top. So I got that Mod Podged in. I just have to go over some flat black where I had it stuck to the table so I could paint it. You'll never be able to see that on the car anyways. So we got our little glass in there. That's what that was for, if you're wondering. We got the frame painted up, got our exhaust all up, then I blacked out the tip. The engine looks great. Painted that up per some pictures I saw. Very basic detail on these engines. They aren't a dressed out motor. Did a little bit of white for the spark plugs, just for a little added detail. Used my craft paints and my tester's paints to make them look nice and separate some components on the engine. What else do I want to show you? I did gloss up the braces for the convertible top so that they look more like metal, a black painted metal. The interior is set to go. You just route the steering column through here. Don't cut all that stuff off. That actually joins up with the front suspension on the chassis, on the frame. Used a white chalk pen to do the gauges and the white that they used to use, and then circled them with a silver pen. I did some of the extra accessories and a little bit of a dressier brass. Some of the mixture and adjustments on the steering wheel, the handbrake. Did those in a brass color on top of the black just to make it just a tiny bit fancier. So, glossed up those seats, left that rubberish flooring black, did the door handles on the inside of the door panels, glossed those up. That looks lovely, and that's going to drop inside the body. Our fenders are all set to go. Did gloss on the top, left them flat on the bottom. Don't need to bother. So, when I get the interior together, I'm going to get the engine in the frame. Before I put it together, I'll get the tire package on and everything. We'll come back for one last look. One final look before I super glue all the final parts together. You can see I got those struts in the mechanical top, in the convertible top there, and that nice gloss on the black just distinguishes that nicely. That will sit on the back like so, with the little ends of it on the outside of the body so it can swivel. We've got all of our small parts ready to go on. I've got my bumper sitting on the side. I've got the little spotlights. I've got the bell. That's the stand for the bell. That's the little bell itself. Painted the bottom black, so when it's together, it'll look a little more realistic. Got my tail light ready to go on the back fender as soon as we got everything together. I always like to glue the smallest parts on the last. Check that out. Does that look sharp or what? That is a nice looking model. Sits on all four. Doesn't rock. Doesn't roll. It's all and those steel axles will hold it steady. We won't have to worry about those sagging or bending over the years. It is a very nice looking assembly. So beautiful and basic. Everything looks nice and straight. That wheel and tire combination with the little chrome hubcaps is outstanding. Beautiful little package all in one there. And then we've got the main body, which we can put completely together before the chassis just goes underneath. In these, you don't have to stretch the body and snap it over the chassis like you do with more modern vehicles. This one, it just lays right down on top of it, and you just tack it on the back and on the front with a little glue, and you're all done. So you can see how nice that black and blue contrast with some flat. Now this needs a couple coats of future, so it'll be even glossier when we're done. Got that windshield on there. That just pushes over with a friction fit. I placed two very small drops of super glue on the corners and pushed it down. That looks awesome. The headlights are in. The grille is in. The hood still comes off, but I've got it in place to hold everything in place while it dries. I've got the hats, the shotgun, the megaphone, the siren. I know the siren they want you to attach to the body, but everyone I've always seen, the guy grabs it and he cranks it by the handle. I went to a fishing resort up in Canada, and they had one of the super old ones from like the 30s, and they use that to call everyone around the lake for dinner, and they just held it in their hand and cranked it up, and it was super loud. So I like that idea better of the guy riding shotgun, leaning out the window, you know, raining it up. That's much more fun to me. So I got the shotgun back there, the megaphone. Each guy's got his helmet in there. He can quick grab it and throw it on. The steering wheel is really high now because I have to place it on the chassis, and then we'll run that steering wheel column down to this link here for the steering on that. It's not posable steering, but it'll look like it's connected. So then all I just have to do is glue the bumpers on, glue the little bumperettes on. I'll use super glue for all that. Put our spotlights on the little corners here, and we're going to be all done. And then I have to decide what decals I want. I will place the decals on the body, then I will give it two coats of future floor polish by brush, and we will be all done. So when I get all that finished, we'll see you at the final. Just like that, my version of the vintage police car from AMT is all said and done. This took me 2 days. The first day, I do my building and major painting, and the second day, I do all the finishing up, the fine details like you saw in the detail section, the painting and detail section, and then the gluing of everything. I always do my final assembly with cheap dollar store super glue to put on all the chrome parts and the bell and the headlights, and I decided to use the side steps on mine, attaching the bumperettes, the tail lights, and everything. I use just very small drops of super glue, paint on paint. I don't scrape anything clean, and it works absolutely fine, and I don't have parts falling off my models all the time. They sit in display cases or in storage cases, and we don't have to worry about that. The side glass looks awesome. It definitely enhances the kit. You don't have to build this as a police car if you don't want. Of course, you can just go ahead and build it as a regular 27T and do it with all the details, or strip it down and make it basic, or you know, another time you'd weather it all up, but you've got all those police accessories. This top removes very easily. It just sets on and off if you don't glue it in place, so you can display it as an open. You can also, don't forget, in the box we had those side curtains, and you could attach those and do it open and closed as you wish and put them on or not. You're gonna have a bunch of police decals, old-timey police decals left over. No matter how you decide to build it, goes together super easy. You have either like the radiator cap like this, or the moto meter. The hood will still pull off. You'll see that at the end of the video in the slideshow. But taking the little top off here, hold on, I see it's easy and then it's spinning on me. There we go. It's spinning on a wobbly turntable as we go. Well, you can see it just comes off real easy, and then you can see that awesome interior, very well detailed. You know, for being an older kit by AMT, I would guess it must be older. It still goes together beautifully without any issues, without any problems. You don't have to fight any parts or do a lot of work. Just remove a little bit of flash and you're all set to go. So I thank Model Roundup for sending this kit over. It is out right now at their website. They sent it to me, got it in my hot little hands as soon as it came into stock, like they will do with you. When you order from it, they ship out all the time, and they ship out super fast. You're never sitting around wondering where your stuff is. I will put a link in the description where this is on Model Roundup website. As always, build the Model T that you want to see, not the one that I want to see, not the one that your friend or somebody online said. You build the one you want to see. Have fun building it, no matter how it turns out, because that's the most important. Stay safe, stay healthy, build a model, and enjoy yourself, and we'll see you at the next review.